First, we have the newsfeed eradicator. Here's the problem. Every time you check Facebook or Instagram or any of these social media platforms, you risk falling in a scrolling spree of 20 minutes and waste your time. Now, the solution is simply not going on these apps. And that's possible for most people, but not for artists, because you, at the very minimum, will have to go on these apps to reply to messages, DMs, comments underneath your art, etc., etc. The newsfeed eradicator extension solves this by changing the newsfeed of these social media platforms into inspirational quotes. And so every time you go on social media, you can only be distracted by an inspirational quote at best. So that was the first one. And as you understand from the title of this video, we have 40 more Chrome extensions that I, as a professional artist, use on a nearly daily basis. All of them are free and none of them are sponsored. And there are some really cool ones. We have Bypass Paywall, which allows you to read any article on any website for free, including the ones that you normally have to pay for. We have Contact Outs, that allows you to get the personal email of anyone in the art world, including some famous people. And we have the Camelizer, which saves money on every online purchase you will make. In other words, I'm 100% sure that your next 10 minutes will be well spent. Let's dive in. The second extension is Colorzilla, which allows you to take any color from any website with a simple eyedropper tool and paste it in any design software that you are using. This is great if you want to steal the color scheme of another artist's painting, or if you want to select some brand colors of a brand because you are making a thumbnail for a YouTube video or an Instagram video where you will feature their product. Next up, we have Go Full Page, which is an extension that allows you to screen capture the entire page of a particular website instead of making multiple screenshots to capture that entire page. This is perfect if you want to capture an entire sales page of a website or a landing page that you want to copy things from, or if you want to capture an entire article that inspires you or things like that. Next up, we have Count Life, which shows you the amount of weeks you have left in your life. As you can see, every time I open a new browser, I see these gray blocks which resemble the amount of weeks that I already had in my life, and the green blocks which resemble the amount of weeks I have left. Most of the times I don't stand still about it, but once a month, for some reason, I look at it, and it really reminds me that life is short and gives me a boost of existential energy to keep on going. Recently, I changed it with the Google Arts and Culture extension, which gives you a new piece of art every time you open the browser. I haven't used it too much yet, but it's very promising and I'm really enjoying learning about art every time I'm opening a new webpage. I hope this one will be more practical and less existential crisis inducing than Count Life, but we'll see. The next one is What Font, and that's exactly what the name suggests. It lets you see which font you are looking at on any website, so that whenever you see a cool font that you want to use in a thumbnail or in an Instagram post, for example, you can immediately know what font it is. Just turn on the extension and hover over any font you want to see, and a small box will appear telling you which font it is. Next up, we have one of my favorite extensions, which is the extension of your love by pressing the like button on my video, which helps out a lot with the algorithm and is kindly appreciated. So thank you very much. Next up, we have Page Marker, which allows you to write on your screen on any website. I personally use this when I'm doing screen recordings and have to clarify particular things, like I have been doing in this video, for example. If I would need to do this in post in Premiere Pro, it would take me so much time that I would likely not even consider doing it in the first place. Great tool for all types of artists who are creating videos for Instagram, YouTube, TikTok, or anything. The next one is Bypass Paywall, which is probably one of my favorites. It allows you to bypass any paywall on the internet. In other words, every time you enter a website like New York Times or Business Insider or Forbes, where you get a pop-up on your screen asking to pay $1 a month in order to read a stupid article, you will never have to pay that $1 and will be able to read everything on their website. It's totally free, but it's a little harder to install. You have to enable the developer mode on your computer and download it from GitHub, which is a little bit more technical, but definitely worth it because you will have access to all web pages on the internet for free. I'm not sure if it's legal and would of course recommend you to always pay for content when you are able to afford it. But if you are young, or you are starting out with your business, or you are a starving artist, then I don't see the ethical issue in using it, to be honest. It's like finding a magazine on the street, not paying for it, but reading it anyway. Next up, we have Contact Out, which is an extension that allows you to get the contact info of anyone who has a LinkedIn page. And the cool thing about this one is that for some reason, they have access to the email address people used to sign up for LinkedIn the first time they used LinkedIn. In other words, you have access to their personal email and not just their professional one, which is great if you want to reach out to journalists and end up in their personal email instead of their business email where 300 other artists are sending to every single week. And this is the case for all LinkedIn pages, including the ones of famous people. And with famous people, I mean the pseudo-famous one, social media influencer types, not the big-ass global fame type of people. The extension is not free and costs quite a lot of money, but I think they also have a free option where you get a particular amount of credits each month or something like that. Next up, we have Video Speed Controller, which is an extension that allows you to change the speed of any video you see on the web. Now, this one is great for people who are able to listen extremely fast. I usually listen at 3 to 4 times faster than normal speed, but YouTube only allows you to listen at a maximum of 2 times the normal speed. But with Video Speed Controller, you can bypass that and put any speed you want. The next one is Build With, which allows you to steal the functionality from other websites. You can, for example, go to a website of successful artists and then see which tools they are using and which plugins and everything. And then you can learn about those tools to see if you could potentially use them yourself and improve your own website. So if you ever wondered, what does Damien Hirst's website have that I don't have? You can just check it out with Build With and realize that Damien Hirst's website doesn't even have a Facebook pixel running on it, for example. Very strange, no Facebook pixel. So Damien, if you are watching this, which you obviously are, of course, then send me a DM. I will fix it for you, for free, of course, for you, because I like your art. Next up, we have Mercury Reader, which makes every website or web page easier to read by taking the images and the text and removing everything else from the web page, meaning all the slideshow things, all the ads, all the other articles that are kind of similar to ads are removed, making the reading experience a much more pleasant reading experience. It's super easy to use. Once installed, you go to any article and then you just use a shortcut, Command plus Escape, to go into reader view of that article, and voila. Here you have it. Next up, we have TubeBuddy and vidIQ. Both are oriented towards YouTubers and provide you with extra insights about the YouTube videos you are watching. We are talking about analytics such as the tags other creators are using on their videos, the saturation levels of particular keywords, or the views per hours the video is actually getting. But my personal favorite feature is seeing the amount of subscribers a video creator has, which is great because with this, you can easily find videos with a lot of views from creators that don't have a lot of subscribers. Which usually indicates that there's a lot of demand for this type of video and not a lot of supply. Now, if you want to install this extension, make sure you use the link in the description, because in order to download and use the extension, you will have to make an account first. Again, this is 100% free and will not cost you anything. Next up is Keywords Everywhere. It's technically not free, although it used to be, but it's so cheap, it's basically free. Keywords Everywhere lets you see the search volume on every keyword you type into Google. In other words, by using Keywords Everywhere, you slowly but steadily become aware of the supply and demand in your marketplace. In my case, I became aware of how many people are searching for information around art, and so it helped me understand what information I should be providing for collectors, for dealers, for artists and art enthusiasts. This is huge, because in business, the rules are simple. Whoever understands best what the customer needs wins. And Keywords Everywhere is one of the best tools to start understanding what people need. Next one is the super simple highlighter, which allows you to highlight text on web pages, which is great if you're reading blog posts or articles for research purposes. By highlighting parts, you make it easier to process information and get back to particular sections of the article after you got distracted and opened some other tabs. And on top of that, it stores the things that you highlighted so that when you want to see all the highlights you made of the last month, you have them grouped together, or when you accidentally press the cross on your browser, you can simply open a new tab, go back to the website and your highlights will still be there. Next up, we have the Camlaser, which is a tool that gives you the price fluctuations of any product that you are considering buying. Here's the thing, prices of products fluctuate dramatically because the prices of the raw materials to make those products fluctuate dramatically. This app makes it possible to see all of that and make better buying decisions because of that. Let's say you are thinking of a new paint set or a new canvas or a new graphics card, for example, and you go on Amazon to buy it, you can see the current price of the product and the lowest and highest price that product has ever had. In other words, you can see if you are making a good deal or not. And so we can see that buying a graphics card during the pandemic, for example, is a really bad idea, and that it's smart to just wait a couple of months for the prices to drop again so that you don't have to pay that 300 euro quarantine surplus. And that said, hope to see you in another video, perhaps even this one, 10 most lucrative art business ideas. Hope to see you there. Ciao, ciao.